How can it be that a company controls genes? How is that possible?
We all know people who have experienced breast cancer.
There are places where the patent system has gone too far, that too much patent protection can in fact trample our civil liberties.
Mothers and daughters are on the front line in the fight against breast cancer. It's also a high-tech battle. To win, scientists need the freedom to research genes and develop diagnostic testing. But one company, Myriad, decides who gets to test and research two genes associated with breast cancer. BRCA1 and 2. All of us, men and women, have these genes. That means the government put a patent on a piece of the human body when it gave Myriad a patent on the BRCA genes.
It doesn't make sense that the government should be able to give people control over human genes. And it's been a long-standing rule of patent law that you can't patent a product of nature or a law of nature.
Mutations on the BRCA genes can mean increased risk of breast and ovarian cancer. Lisbeth Ceriani had breast cancer that resulted in a double mastectomy. If she has a mutation on her BRCA gene, it could signal more cancer to come.
As a single mother, I'd like to see my daughter graduate from college. And if I have the mutation, there's a huge chance that I'll end up with ovarian cancer in the immediate future.
But because the government granted a patent on both the genes and any mutations, Myriad is the only place Lisbeth can turn to see if she's more likely to get ovarian cancer.
It's like the government created this monopoly by giving them the patent, by giving Myriad the patent in the first place. I don't know what they're thinking.
Like many women, Lisbeth can't afford the more than $3,000 Myriad wants for the test, and getting it covered by insurance can be complicated or impossible.
I don't even have a credit card sitting there with $300 that I could just charge and have it be done. I need to have that test so I can get them out if I need to before anything happens. I don't really like those odds.
Dr. Wendy Chung, a clinician and geneticist at Columbia University, says there are problems with the patents beyond cost. The patents limit information that is crucial to women and their doctors.
So for women, as they're trying to make these major life decisions, it's very helpful for them to have a second opinion, much as they would get a second opinion for a surgeon. By having only a single laboratory offering that testing, it's impossible really to be able to get that second opinion, either in the way that the test is performed or the interpretation of such a result. And that's been problematic for women in the field.
You know, ovary removal is, you are deciding whether or not you can have children. And to me, that's a huge, huge decision. I did not have the option to go to anybody else to validate the test. And that is very scary when you're a patient.
Minority women have an additional concern, genetic variants of uncertain significance. Initial gene studies focused on white women, and now the patents make it more difficult to learn what some mutations mean in women of color. Because Myriad has total control over researchers' access to those mutations.
It's really frustrating not to be able to have this information, because I would love to be able to find out why, and not just for myself, but other Asians also. I believe in being proactive about my health, and having that patent makes it really difficult to be very proactive.
They own not only the gene, they own any future test, any future drug, any future therapy. So it means that we're putting our trust in one single company.
We're asking the court to declare the patents invalid. If the court does that, then the tens of thousands of researchers around the country who have the technical ability to look at breast cancer genes can do that freely.
We need better options, and the research on these genes might get us to that, but not if Myriad holds all the cards.
As a women's rights advocate, I think we're really concerned anytime we see the government interfering with something so elemental as women's bodies.
We don't do cases in order to win an abstract principle. We do cases that are going to affect people's lives, and this case will affect people's lives.
So, who but the ACLU?